A video game mechanic I love is Fortnite wall construction. Let's challenge ourselves by creating a custom version using Unity 3D. I promise I harm no players filming this video. Maybe. The first thing to do is analyze the construction process frame by frame. Many details and effects succeed one another to accomplish the result. Switching to the building mode creates a bluish wall in front of the character. We call this the ghost wall. It previews the construction position and it turns red if you try to build on an invalid zone. Confirming with the left mouse button starts the building phase. The ghost wall gets brighter and a health bar appears. Concrete bricks start popping up from the ground, covering the ghost wall. The orange bar keeps updating its value, suggesting the remaining construction time. The process ends at 300 points. The bar turns green, the concrete wall lights up, and the particle system simulates a sort of incandescent dust. Now the brick wall is complete. It stays still until a player tries to destroy it. Let's see what happens on the contrary. On a hit, the wall drops some bricks uncovering the ghost wall. It becomes red for a moment, there are some flying rocks, and the wall starts bouncing, propagating the bounce from the impact point. When it reaches 0 points, it disappears and some effects play. In particular, a shiny hit effect, smoke, and some rocks. It's our turn to create a lookalike mechanic. Mr. Banana is going to help us with explanations. All the links to these great assets are in the video description. I remember that this video is not a step-by-step tutorial. The goal is to understand the processes and ideas behind complex game dev mechanics. If you desire to learn more about a particular topic, just ask in the comment section. Also, great opportunity here. We are currently using Rider to write the code. On Ozone IDE by JetBrains that's fully integrated into Unity. JetBrains allowed us to gift one license to one of you. Watch until the end to find out how you can win it. Let's get into Unity 3D. The first step is placing the ghost wall. To do so, we need the 3D model. I created it using Blender. Just align some parallel pipettes and move their vertices to a discontinuity. The ghost effect is achievable with a custom shader. Let's use the shader graph to create it. The blue parts are more transparent than the white borders. There's also a pattern that breaks the flatness of the base colors. I'm going to achieve that with an unlit setup and two texture maps. I unwrap the wall model and start to create the funniest one, the border map. By hand painting, I get irregular lines. The graph is simple, it takes our texture as input and reads its alpha value. If the alpha value is 0, we are working in the inner area, otherwise with the edges. In the first case, we use a blue color. In the second case, we multiply the texture color for a custom one. I end the visual by adding another detail map to the output. With the same idea, I create the shader for the concrete wall. This time, the alpha value doesn't matter since the material is opaque. The difference is that here we have also a normal map that adds some details. As soon as Banana finds the right construction place, we press the left mouse button to place the wall. The ghost wall turns white for a few seconds, expressing confirmation feedback. This is just a lerp operation between blue and white over time. Meanwhile, the health bar appears. The fastest way to create it is by using a slider. The background is dark and transparent, while the front bar is orange. There's also a little white line on the right side. Let's add another little sprite anchored to the orange one. We now need to increase the slider value over time programmatically. At max health points, the bar turns green. What about the concrete wall? Our goal is to have some bricks fly into specific position. You can probably achieve this effect in many ugly ways, but the splendid one is thanks to a shader. In particular, a vertex shader. In brief, the idea is to displace the bricks from the original position with an offset and move them back gradually to the starting point. But the bricks are part of a single mesh. We need a way to isolate and identify blocks of vertices. The answer is vertex colors. A vertex is a data structure that can save some information. One of these is color. Back to Blender, and in particular in the vertex paint section, I colored the bricks in a grayscale. The shader can now access these colors to isolate and move specific parts of the wool mesh. I took this graph from a tweet of Ciro Continisio, a very passionate and professional game dev. I highly suggest following him. Also, be sure to follow us and turn on the notification bell. We just need to animate the float number, called progress, and our bricks move. With the concrete bricks in place, we notice a problem. The meshes are overlapping. To resolve this, I export a bigger wall. At the end of the bricks animation, there is another color transition, and a particle system plays. It's a sort of glowing dust falling from the wall. Half of the work is done. On a hit, the wall drops pieces and undercover the ghost wall beneath. The first step is to play back the construction animation. The problem is that the concrete wall has too many shades of gray on the bricks. This is good for the construction phase, but now discontinuity prevents us to find a good animation stopping point without flying bricks. So, I export another wall that replaces the first one as soon as the construction phase ends. On this, I apply only 4 vertex colors, obtaining a discrete subdivision. I can now animate the progress value of a fixed amount, ensuring at least 4 safe stopping points. I update the health bar accordingly. At this point, there is another feature missing in our vertex shader, the bouncing effect. The bounce propagates from the hit point and decreases its strength in a few seconds. On collision, the shader takes in the hit word position. It checks the distance between that point and each vertex and uses these distance values to offset the vertices on the z-axis by a proportionate amount. Vertices nearest to the impact point move farther. A float value sets the radius, while a curve controls the strength. The ghost shader needs this effect too. Now the last touches. The walls disappears after 4 hits. The destruction effect sees a particle system with a yellow cartoony star and smoke. On each hit, the wall drops also some 3D little rocks. I spawn them and add an explosive force at their base. After a few adjustments, this is the final result. It's incredible how many forms of art and ideas are behind the mechanics of good video games. All studied to give you determined feedback and please the gamer's eyes. I hope that you enjoyed the video. Any comment is welcome and appreciated. As we said, JetBrains supported us with an extra annual license for one of their IDE. Try to win it! To participate in the raffle, subscribe to the channel, click the like button, and fill out the form in the description below. See you in the next video. Bye!